So when you're tensile testing, particularly polymer samples, we use this very characteristic shape of the samples. This is known as a dog bone or a dumbbell shape. You have your tab or end regions, your sloping shoulder regions, and then your gauge length, which is the bit we test in the middle. This shape is particularly important for the testing as it directs the pull longitudinally down the gauge length. It's also important to visually check your samples before you do any of the testing. Make sure there's no excess material down the sides, any bits of sprue for example, and make sure there's no visible defects anywhere in the gauge length.
The first sample we're going to break is a piece of natural rubber. In order to make a secure connection to the machine, we use this particular grip. This grip has a knurled spring-loaded roller, which, when we place the specimen in, grips tightly, and as we strain the sample, it provides a secure, non-slip grip. For the plastic samples, in this case a piece of HDPE, we use a different type of gripping assembly. We use these screw wedge grips. These wedge grips have a serrated face, which when we place the sample in and screw up tightly, grip the sample and prevent any slippage. Actually paused the test at the moment because this machine isn't capable of breaking this specimen. The specimen will extend the full length of the frame. The next material is 30% glass filled nylon. Again, I check the dimensions of the sample along the gauge length area. Then input the dimensions on the computer. Start the test. Dimensional accuracy is important, especially when we're inputting the width and thickness of the sample. So I check with a micrometer, with a vernier caliper, the thickness and width of the sample. Take an average of the readings and then place the sample within the machine. Then input the dimensions. And we start the test.
samples experiment, we conduct our testing on a piece of 0.4% carbon steel. The difference between the three samples that we're testing is the heat treatment that they've undergone. So the first sample, the sample that we're going to test, is in the normalised condition, which means it's been heat treated to 860 degrees C. It's been then taken out of the furnace and allowed to air cool. The samples, again, are in this dog bone configuration. Before I start the test, we need to measure the diameter of the sample. Which is 5.02 millimetres. We then connect the sample to the tensometer via these collet chokes. The sample is trapped within the collet choke. There's then a retaining ring that goes over, and it then sits on the bottom nose piece, this piece of the tensometer being the bottom nose piece. Then make a connection. Top to the nose and one side. Put the safety screen on. Start the test. Just identify the sample. Input the dimensions. And the test is underway. This is the second sample we're going to test. Again, it's 0.4 carbon steel. The difference from the first sample is this has been quenched, so it's been heat treated to 860 degrees C and then it's been plunged into oil to rapidly cool it. I've inputted the dimensions of the sample on the PC, so if we just start the test, we'll see what effect that heat treatment has had on the strength and properties of the material. The test's now underway. This final sample has been quenched down temperature, so it's gone through exactly the same quenching process in that it's been heat treated to 860 degrees C and then quenched into oil. After the oil, it's then been placed back in a furnace at 550 degrees C. So we'll see what effect that tempering procedure has made on the structural properties of the material. I've inputted the diameter once again, so I'll just click OK on the screen. Test.